Good afternoon, students. In today's video, I will discuss about the law of gearing. So, what is the law of gearing and what is the importance of law of gearing and what is the condition of law of gearing? So, I will discuss the statement of law of gearing in later half. I have drawn here two profile, two gear profile, profile number 1 and profile number 2. Both profile have contact at this point, or we can say that the point C of gear profile 1 is in contact with the point D of gear profile 2. The point D of gear profile 2. So, at the point of contact, both the gear profile have a common tangent TT and have a common normal N at the point of contact. The point A is the center of rotation of the gear 1 and point B is the center of rotation of the gear profile 2. So, we have joined the point A to the point B, and AB is basically known as center line of the two gear tooth profile. Yeah. So, the center line AB intersect the common normal NN at the point P. And we have also joined the point C to point A and point D to point B. So, point C, gear A rotating with angular velocity omega 1 in clockwise direction, and gear B rotating with angular velocity omega 2 in anti-clockwise direction. So if we will talk about the point C, the point C have a velocity perpendicular to the link AC. So point C have velocity VC perpendicular to the link A and C, and point D have a velocity perpendicular to the link BD and have a velocity VD. Velocity of VC makes an angle alpha with the common normal, and the velocity VD makes an angle beta with the common normal. So, diagram is clear. I am again repeating, the point A and B is the center of rotation of the two profile 1 and 2. 1 is rotating in clockwise direction. So, the rotation of the both profile 2 will be anti-clockwise direction. Both the profile had the point of contact at point C and D. A point C is in contact with point D. So, at the point of contact, TT is the common tangent and NN is the common normal. In common normal, intersect at the center line AB at point P. The velocity of C is a VC, which is makes an angle alpha with the common normal, and a velocity D have a velocity VD, which makes an angle beta to the common normal. So, if we will talk about the component of VC along the common normal. The component of Vc along the common normal will be Vc cos alpha, and the component of Vd along the common normal is the Vd cos beta. So I am writing some terms. Velocity of Vc equal to omega 1, velocity of Vc equal to omega 1 multiplied by its perpendicular distance, or perpendicular distance is AC. So Vc equal to omega 1 AC, and if we will talk about the Vd, so Vd equal to omega 2 multiplied by its perpendicular distance BD. So omega 2 multiplied by perpendicular distance BD. Here you see, here I have drawn a perpendicular from the point A and from the point B to the common normal. So this is the point E and this is the point A. Both have a perpendicular. So if this angle is beta, then this angle will be also beta. And if this angle is alpha, then this angle will be also alpha. How it will comes beta? This is the beta. So the remaining angle is 90 minus beta, and this is 90, so it will be beta. So there are two things here. One gear tooth profile have sliding velocity. One gear tooth profile have always slides along the common tangent. You have already read in previous that velocity is always tangential. So one gear tooth profile always have a velocity along the tangent direction. And second, the most important point is one gear tooth profile is always transmitting force along the common normal. And another most important term, the relative velocity along the common normal will always equal to zero. Why it is important? It is important because if one gear tooth profile will transmit velocity along the common normal, then what will happen? The base of the one gear tooth profile insert with the tip of the another gear tooth profile. So that is the interlocking between the two gear tooth profile. To prevent the interlocking or penetration of one gear tooth profile to the other gear tooth profile, it is always necessary that the relative velocity along the common normal should equal to zero. So the velocity of Vc along the common normal is equal to Vc cos alpha, and the velocity of Vd along the common normal is equal to Vd cos beta. So if we will talk about the relative velocity along the common normal, so it will be Vc cos alpha minus Vd cos beta. So I have already discussed that ki relative velocity along the common normal should equal to zero. That's why it is equal to zero. Here put the value of VC. VC is equal to omega 1 AC. So omega 1 AC into cos alpha minus VD equal to omega 2 BD. Omega 2 BD into cos beta equal to 0. Put the value of cos alpha and cos beta. So cos alpha equal to AE divided by AC and cos beta equal to BF divided by BD. So I am writing next in next step omega 1 AC multiplied by AE divided by AC minus omega 2 BD BF divided by BD equal to 0. So both are cancelled. Omega 1 AE equal to omega 2 BF. So omega 1 divided by omega 2 equal to BF divided by AE. Similar triangle A EP and BFP B, we can write here BF divided by EA equal to BP divided by AP equal to FP divided by PE. So I am writing the relation BF divided by AE equal to BP divided by AP equal to FP divided by PE. So here BF divided by AP, BF divided by AP equal to BP divided by AP. So we can write here omega 1 divided by omega 2 equal to BP divided by AP, because I have already discussed that BF divided by AE equal to BP divided by AP. So you can visualize that what will this equation show. This equation shows that omega 1 basically is the angular velocity of gear tooth profile 1 and omega 2 is the angular velocity of the gear tooth profile 2 and P is the point where both center line intersect at the point P. So you can say that the center line AB is divided at P by the common normal is the inverse ratio of angular velocity of the two gears. And basically this is the desired condition of the two gear tooth profile. And another one is, in another terms, we can say that the point of contact of the two teeth should always pass through a fixed point P, which divide the line of center, which divide the line of center in the inverse ratio of the angular velocity of the two gears. So this is the basically necessary condition. The center line is the common normal divided at center line at fixed point P, which is the inverse ratio of angular velocity of the two gear. This is the necessary condition of the two gears to maintain the contact between the two gears. If this condition will not satisfy, then both gear will either penetrate or separate to each other. So in next step, I am trying to calculate the velocity of the sliding. I have already discussed that one gear profile always slides along the common tangents. Always slides along the common tangents. So we have to calculate the velocity along the common tangents. So component of VC along the common tangent will be VC sin alpha, and component of VD along the common tangent is VD sin beta. So velocity of the sliding equal to VC sin alpha minus VD sin beta equal to, we can write here the value of VC is omega 1 AC, and we can write also write here the value of sin alpha. So it will be equal to EC divided by AC minus the value of VD is equal to omega 2 VD multiplied by the, you can also put here the value of sin beta, which is equal to FD divided by BD. So the AC and BD cancel. So omega 1 EC minus omega 2 FD. So you can write here in place of EC equal to EP equal to PC. So I am writing here omega 1 EP plus PC minus omega 2. The value of FD is equal to, the value of FD equal to FP minus PD. The value of FD means this value is equal to this FP minus PD. So I am writing here FP minus PD. So you can solve omega 1 EP plus omega 1 PC minus omega 2 FP plus omega 2 PD. So we can write here P and C at the coincidence points. So the P points, C and D is the coincidence point, so C point equal to D. So I am replacing here omega 1 EP plus omega 1 PC minus omega 2 FP plus omega 2. I am writing C in place of D, so it will be equal to PC. So PC both equal to omega 1 plus omega 2 into PC. So omega 1 plus omega 2 equal multiplied by PC plus omega 1 EP minus omega 2 FP. From this equation, you can write here the value of FP divided by AE equal to BP divided by AP equal to FP divided by P equal to omega 1 divided by omega 2. Omega 1 divided by omega 2. So, if we will equate this value FP divided by PE FP divided by PE equal to omega 1 divided by omega 2. So omega 1 PE my equal to omega 2 FP. So from the above relation, omega 1 PE equal to omega 2 FP, so this become equal to 0. So sliding velocity equal to omega 1 plus omega 2 multiplied by PC. So if you want to calculate the sliding velocity, so sliding velocity is the basically summation of angular velocity of the two profile omega 1 plus omega 2 multiplied by the distance between the pitch point to the point of contact. So PC is the distance between the pitch point to the point of contact. So okay, today is enough for it. So you will need to practice how to calculate the sliding velocity and what is the statement of law of gearing. I am again repeating the law of gearing. Law of gearing basically very necessary to maintain the constant angular velocity between the two gears, and law of gearing state that the common normal is always passed through the fixed point P, which divide the center line at any fixed point P, and also the inverse ratio of angular velocity of the two gears to profile. So okay students, thanks.